Hey guys, welcome to the 9th episode of Building JavaScript Projects. In this episode, we'll be building an what you call a counter timer like this, where you'll set the time, and for that particular time or the day, a decreasing counter timer will start running. Okay, similar to this, you'll build. Let's start making the project. So basically, I don't want to waste time using this easy JavaScript and CSS part. If you find this as difficult, I'll leave the what you call the link for the source code in the description box. Just access it. Okay, this is how it looks like before adding the JavaScript or interactivity. So let's start with this const what you call count needed. Sorry, I spelled the count as cotton. Count needed is equals to assign a date, new date. I'll assign what you call what date. Let me take the February 1, comma, what's this year? Okay, it's 2021, space, the very first day of February, that is 00 hour, minute and second. Okay, now let me declare a function called I have declared an event here called start in this div with a ID container. Let me take that event as a function name here, start. Okay, I declare a variable called sub. Okay, I'll declare a variable called need. That need is equals to new date. This is not need. This is the current date what we use for representing purposes. Now this sub is equals to count needed minus current, the needed count date minus the the count needed date minus the current date of the timeline gives the, I mean, that data will be stored in the variable called sub. And let's start other things. Let second is equals to 1000. I mean, that's like, it takes it as like 1000 millisecond, which is actually 1 second. Now let minute, that's equals to second multiplied by 60. Let hour, that's equals to minute multiplied by 60, because 60 second make 1 minute, whereas 60 minute make an hour. Let day is equals to hour multiplied by 60. Okay, now what we'll do is we want to grab the date for which we want to start. For that, we'll do like this. I'll declare a variable called variable, we have used day, right? So I declare it as day one. Okay, what I'll do is I'll say math dot floor sub divided by day. Okay, so here we have declared a variable called sub, and we have stored the what the needed date for us minus the what current timeline or the current date and time of your place time or timeline. We have stored that data into this variable called sub, and in we have declared another variable called day one, and we are dividing the sub, what do you call what the data of the sub here, we are dividing it by the day. Okay, and math.floor is used to round off the numbers. Now where minute one, that's equals to math.floor, the whole divided by minute. Let's copy this thing three times. Change this variable names. Minute, it's second. Place it just over the minute so that your har, which is disabled, will come here. Har, what I'll do is I'll just replace the minute by har. Now minute one, so here it is. Take out the day with the har day, and minute is har. Let it be minute itself. Here it is second, and here it is minute. Okay, now just use document.getElementById dot getElementById, and the IDs are ID goes like this: day dot inner HTML, that's equals to inner HTML is equals to day one. And just paste it four times, change the day to minute. Status 404 not found. Okay, so minute second. What mistake did we do here? So it's showing like this. There is some error which I don't know what happened. Okay, let's do this now. What do you call? Set interval, start for every 1 second. Yes, it's working. You can see that every time a new time is generated, and that is printed on this what you call console, and the date we took is February 1, 2021, and it's showing 8 days 1 hour. Oh my god, it's actually not 8 days. Let me take it as 18. Okay, here You have to multiply it by 24, not 60, because each day has 24 hours. And now it's fine. It is showing 37 days, 1 hour, 10 minute, and 55 seconds, 54 seconds to go. So this is how you build a countdown timer using JavaScript. Okay. You can also add user intake by using prompt here. So okay, thank you for watching this. Also, if you like the video, then hit a subscription button below for more projects.